England and Australia drew their only test match in the Women's Ashes series after the host turned down the opportunity to chase down an unlikely 249 runs to win in 45 overs on the last day of the game in Wormsley. The draw looked inevitable as the final morning got underway, with the Aussies on 64 for 1 in their second innings. Their leader moved along to 89 when the impressive Anya Shrubsole found Meg Lanning's leading edge to have her caught at mid-off by Aaron Brindle. Indeed, England started the day strongly. Only 12 runs had been added to the overnight score when Sarah Elliott was run out, courtesy of an exceptional bit of fielding by Lydia Greenway in the covers. That put Australia on 76 for 3 for a lead of 93, and a sudden collapse from here would have opened the door for England, who'd fought back superbly on the third day. Alex Blackwell and Jess Cameron prevented that from happening, however, as they saw out a dozen overs in adding 32 runs for the fourth wicket. England were working hard with the ball, and deservedly Jenny Gunn picked up the wicket of Cameron on 24 as she clipped to Charlotte Edwards at mid-wicket. You could see from England's reaction there that they still fancied their chances, but any opportunity they did have of bowling their opponents out was ruined by the visiting captain Jodie Fields, who was soon taking the game away from her opponents. Fields had shown a positive intent throughout this contest, and there was no change in her approach as she played her shots, dominating a fifth wicket partnership of 42 with Blackwell. Fields was especially strong, and anything dropped in too short by Gunn. Still, England managed to pick up a fourth wicket before lunch as Laura Marsh trapped Blackwell in front on the sweep for 22. So England still had an outside chance as the afternoon session began, but Fields was soon ensuring that it was her side which held the whip hand. She reached a 50 off 95 balls in an innings which started to send her country clear. She was helped in that by Erin Osborne, who'd had a good match with both bat and ball. The two soon began to play brightly together as they started to dream of setting a target and trying to put England under pressure at the end of the match, one which has ebbed and flowed throughout. The declaration came at 231 for 5, with Fields unbeaten on 78, and that left the home side 249 to get. That was never really on, especially after the first innings heroine, Heather Knight, was run out for the second time in 2 days, this time for just 4 rather than 157. It was certainly a wicket which would have galvanised the tourists, who now had 40 overs to bag another 9 wickets. The idea of that happening was knocked on the head by Brindle and Sarah Taylor, who kept their wickets intact in spite of some attacking fields for the next 14 overs, without ever threatening to attempt to chase down the formidable target they'd been offered. So in spite of these boundaries, the last session was really about batting out time to take 2 points each ahead of the next stage of this Ashes series, 3 ODIs, the first which begins next week. The last wicket of this match was the one of Brindle, who drove a well-flighted delivery from Elliott back to the bowler after making 20. So the remainder of the match was nothing more than a prolonged outdoor net session for Taylor and Edwards. Two players will be expecting to shine in the forthcoming ODIs and T20 matches that make up this Ashes series. Both emphasised their skills in their time together as they put on 45 in 14 overs for the third wicket, Taylor making 38 and Edwards 23. That meant that England ended on 93 for 2 from 34 overs to take the draw, meaning that each side claimed 2 points. The same amount are on offer for a win in each of the 3 ODIs which are up next, the first of which takes place at Lord's on August the 20th.